Dublin, capital of Ireland and center of the Irish spirit. For Ireland is a nation of heroes, and here in Dublin, heroes are born, not made. Indeed, not all of Ireland's heroes were men of the sword, for Ireland had no greater hero, no bolder champion of the people than the famed writer, Sean O'Casey. With words as sharp as any sword, he lashed out against tyranny, depicting for all the world the plight of the Irish people, whom he knew so well. O'Casey, perhaps more than any man, typifies the audacity, the doughtiness, the hot temper and the quick, elusive humor that mark the Irish spirit. He grew up in Dublin on streets such as this, knowing the hard times and the unrest that would soon erupt into the violence of war. He belonged to these people. He was one of them, and their struggles were his. Their actions gave stimulus to his words, and in turn, his words stimulated them to action. He stood and fought beside them, but it was Sean O'Casey's keen sensitivity, his ability to articulate the passionate feelings of these, his friends and neighbors among Dublin's working class, that made him unique in literature and history. Around this brawling, boisterous period of vitality and excitement, around this heroic figure of Sean O'Casey, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer has fashioned a motion picture that captures all the lusty spirit and momentous adventure that is unique in any history. Impressive talents are called upon. John Ford, whose name is synonymous with the spirit of Ireland and the art of film. Producers Robert Graff and Robert Emmett Guinea. Director Jack Cardiff.
It always fills me with a sense of horror and shame that you change a nice, peaceful Irish street into a circus.
And to play the title role of young Sean O'Casey, the distinguished Australian actor Rod Taylor. And so, this era of Sean O'Casey is born again on film in Young Cassidy, based on O'Casey's own autobiographical writings. To prepare for his role as Young Cassidy, Rod Taylor went to the people of Dublin. He found them willing to impart their knowledge of customs and traditions, and they, too, found him eager and willing to absorb it all. But the business of filmmaking is a serious one. And Rod Taylor, with the help of the eminent British director Jack Cardiff, worked hard to assume the complex character of Sean O'Casey.
Is it funnier if when she comes down, I immediately start to whisper, has it sold on the other angle? Will you come on down? You know, has it sold enough on there to start whispering here? Or shall I still say, I just wanted to apply?
That's right. I thought the second way, yes. I thought the second way is funnier.
What? Whisper from the very beginning?
No, not whisper, but start loud.
Start loud.
Yeah, if you want to.
I just wanted to
apologize. I think it's better.
Yeah. Good.
Now, it's a very dangerous thing for anyone to interfere with a member of the royal...
And Taylor's own zest for fun and excitement and for personal expression gives added credence to the superbly drawn character he plays.
Would you put me poor little brother down, please?
What, sir?
Me poor little brother, would you put him down, or God will never forgive you.
Thank you, sir.
You see, the Almighty will love you. You know, up there. We're off!
There is another side of Sean O'Casey, shown in his tender love for Nora, played by the fine English actress Maggie Smith.
Will you go away?
I will not. Will you come down?
I will not. My father will be home for his supper in a minute. Will you please go away?
No! Come down.
Her delicate nature stands in sharp contrast to his rough and sometimes awkward manner.
You don't understand.
What do you mean by that?
Well, it's just that you're more afraid than you like to say. You need the safety of your crowded tenement just as much as Yates needs the safety of his great house. It's just that sometimes you condemn for the wrong reasons, Johnny. That's all.
Oh, my darling.
Their deeply felt love is also in contrast to the brashness and boldness of the many other women who enter the life of young Cassidy, like the exciting Daisy Battles and the enticing Mrs. Balanoy. Sean O'Casey's passion for adventure found expression everywhere, with the women in his life, in the many volumes of stories, poems, and plays that bear his name, and on the thundering battlefields of the rebellion. But always the spirit was the same. Around him and in him, it was the spirit of the unconquerable and the unquenchable. The spirit that meets hard times and gay times alike with a raised glass, a clenched fist, and a joy in life and all that it offers. The spirit of Sean O'Casey, Ireland, and young Cassidy.